Township of Sacramento served as their own general contractor and builder, and I, as chairman of the Building Steering Committee, wish to present the key to our vice chairman of the congregation, and with that, I let him finish this building off. I don't think he knew that. So I sprung this on to him that he has finished the building. As you know, we're not true Christians will tell the good Lord knows everything, so might as well get it out. We are going to be in this building kind of illegally. Anyway, we did not get a temporary occupancy on Friday. I got a late call from the city and said that we need to do a few more items, but we hope to do them in the next week or two. But anyway, that's where we are, and Doug, I present the key to you.
Thank you. I like that.
Wilbur Hall.
Wilbur.
Thank you.
remember that this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I'd like to take a moment of silence for each of the members, our visitors, friends, and relatives, to pray to God that we here at Trinity will move forward with Christ with the use of this building. I also come with a heavy heart today and would like to take a moment of silence in memory of Chet Henderson, the person who had a lot to do with getting this fellowship hall going. We want to thank God for giving us Chet to serve his Lord here at Trinity. Thank you. And an answer to the children that sang up in front, yes, I love my Jesus, and I hope we all do. And I'd like to read two letters that came to us, one from our district president, Walter Teachin. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, with the completion of your fellowship hall, a long-awaited dream has been fulfilled. I regret that my schedule will not permit me to celebrate with you on this occasion of the dedication, August 14, 1994. Speaking for all the ministries of the California, Nevada, Hawaii district, I pray that this facility will serve as a rich resource for the ministry of Trinity Congregation as Trinity Congregation continues its long tradition of discipling people our gracious God is pleased to call his very own. The Lord continue to bless you in his service. Your partner in Christ's mission, Walter C. Teachin, District President. I have one other letter from Pastor Pinscher's oldest son, Carl Pinscher. Dear friends, congratulations on the dedication of your beautiful new fellowship hall this coming Sunday. It's a place, a facility that still maintains a very warm place in my heart, where in 1937 I was confirmed downstairs and graduated upstairs. When we enjoyed many years of worship of our Lord and Savior downstairs, and many fun activities and a treasured Christian education upstairs. Christine and I are confident that the new building will follow in this rich tradition. We will be with you in spirit, if not in the flesh. Our warmest best wishes for a happy celebration day. In his name, Carl Kinchin. The rest of what I have to say is just off the top of my head. I told Pastor, if I'm not writing it down, maybe I won't take quite so long. Maybe I'll take longer. I don't know. Pastor Heckman had how many minutes left? Maybe I can tie in with something. As I pull these flags out, in appreciation for all the ones that served on our steering committee, they're not necessarily in order, and so however they're stacked here, that's the way they're coming out. First is Alvina Eck. Alvina, I want to thank you very much for all the work that you did on our committee, especially me. Thank you. heading up the cleaning of our church, the cleaning of this fellowship hall, making sure that the members were here, at least asking them to be here, and steering that part of it up, and many other things during the period of time that we had our committee going. Thank you very much, Brian, for your help. Lost somewhere, so he's down.